Do you know how air gets polluted? Well, the answer is pretty much interesting. The fossil fuel, firewood, and other things that we burn produce oxides of carbon that are released into the atmosphere, and this makes the air polluted. Earlier, there were a large number of trees that would easily filter the air that we breathe in. But now, with the increase in demand for land, we had to cut down the trees which have caused deforestation and ultimately reduce the filtering capacity of the trees. Moreover, the number of fossil fuel burning vehicles have also increased rapidly, which has increased the number of pollutants in the air.
Include the burning of fossil fuel and firewood smoke released from factories, volcanic eruptions, forest fires, bombardment, asteroids, and many more. Besides, there are some other air pollutants like industrial waste, agricultural waste, power plants, thermal nuclear plants, etc. The greenhouse effect is also a cause of air pollution because air pollution produces the gases that the greenhouse involves. Besides, it increases the temperature of Earth's surface to such an extent that the polar caps are melting and most of the UV rays are easily penetrating the surface of the Earth. Effects of air pollution on the environment. Global warming is a direct consequence of the greenhouse effect, which is produced by the high emission of CO2 and methane into the atmosphere. When the temperature of the planet increases, there's a disturbance in the usual climatic cycle, accelerating the changes of these cycles in an evident way. When toxic gases accumulate in the atmosphere and react with water, they form dilute solutions of nitric and sulfuric acid. And when those concentrations become the acid rain, both the environment and surfaces suffer. The smog effect or Perret effect happens when there is a kind of dark fog concentrated over the cities and fields. Contaminated water and gases seep in onto the earth, changing the composition of soils, which directly affect agriculture, changing crop cycles and the composition of the food we all eat. Deforestation and poor soil quality add to the disappearance of ecosystems and habitats. It causes a certain imbalance in the behavior of many wild species. Air pollutants also deteriorate and change the constitution of building materials. So many buildings and infrastructure are weakened, eroded, or destroyed at an accelerated rate over time. People develop intolerances and allergies to many agents present in the atmosphere and to other external agents that can go through due to the holes in the ozone layer. Effects of air pollution on health has many bad effects on health of people. It is the cause of many skin and respiratory disorders in human beings. Also, it can cause heart diseases as well. Air pollution may cause asthma, bronchitis, and many other diseases. Moreover, it increases the rate of aging of lungs, decreases lung function, damages cells in the respiratory system. Ways to reduce air pollution. Although the level of air pollution has reached a critical point, there are still ways by which we can reduce the number of air pollutants from the air. The quality of air can be improved by planting more and more trees as they clean and filter the air. Strict policy for industries related to the filter of gases should be introduced in the country so that we can minimize the toxins released from factories. We have to adopt to the usage of eco-friendly fuels such as LPG, CNG, biogas, and other eco-friendly fuels so that we can reduce the amount of harmful toxic gases. The air we breathe is getting more and more polluted day by day. Humans have taken this problem seriously and are devotedly working up to eradicate the problem that they have created. Many initiatives like plant trees, use of eco-friendly fuel are now promoted worldwide. Remember friends, it's time even we add a bit in reducing the air pollution levels. What do we need to do? Spread the awareness amongst our friends and family. Urge them to reduce the usage of fossil fuels. Switch off the lights and electrical devices when not needed. limit the use of private cars, rather make use of public transport systems. Little by little, step by step, we will start to see the difference, and the world will once again be a happy place to live in. Hey there, hope you liked our video. Before you go, please click on the like button. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Please hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our interesting videos. Comment down below with what other topics would you want us to cover. Do share these with your friends and family.